Phones at Dr. Rob, just reading here a story headlined, "No Longer in Shadows, Pentagon's UFO Unit Will Make Some Findings Public." It says here, for over a decade, the program, now tucked inside the Office of Naval Intelligence, has discussed mysterious events in classified briefings, but they're about, apparently, to unveil some of what they've been able to discover over the years. What are you expecting out of this, Dr. Rob? Anything in anything that would really jump out at you at all?
No.
No?
No, I mean, so that they regularly do these disclosures. And so, for example, there was a few months ago, there was disclosure of some footage that had already been leaked, but they said, okay, we're officially going to release it. And you know, some of these things are difficult to explain. Let's not get away from that. There may be experimental aircraft of other powers or whatever. But at the end of the day, no, Rick, I'm not expecting us to see real evidence of alien civilizations that just happen to fly around in our atmosphere rather than saying hello.
But they have filmed, I guess, some rather, I don't know, I'll call them rather mysterious kind of flying machines. I mean, you've seen some of these videos, I'm sure.
There's certainly video of things that look unusual. I will completely agree with you on that. And there's also information with radar tracking of things that look unusual. Radar tracking, I'm less sort of concerned about. It's known how you can have flares happen in radar signals, unusual tracking, and so on. But the video stuff is a little bit more hard to explain. Although, for example, with one of the movies that was released a few months ago, there was something that was moving ahead, but it was always pretty much in the same position on the head-up display, which kind of makes you think that was something that was coming through the tracking system or something like that. Mm. So, I'm not saying there aren't unusual things. The whole point of the phrase unidentified flying object is that there are things in the sky that you don't know what they are. But it doesn't necessarily mean that they are aliens from another planet.
No, it doesn't. But again, there's some mystery out there. In fact, I'm just reading some comments from Senator Marco Rubio, who has a concern about unidentified or strange aircraft flying around U.S. military bases, which to me would suggest perhaps the Russians, the Chinese, or, you know, some force like that that may be some new technology or something.
Yeah, it's certainly the case that if you go back to the 50s and 60s, the U.S. was particularly concerned about this for the obvious intelligence reason. But the one thing to remember about a lot of intelligence stuff is those tended to be higher flying aircraft. We think of the Lockheed SR-71 and things like that. So things that are low flying that are about intelligence, those would be a lot rarer and a lot really more difficult to build and hide with stealth technologies and so on.
But there have been some pretty good TV shows over the years about Project Blue Book and stuff like that. It's a fascinating topic, I find, anyway.
It makes for awesome TV. I'm not going to suggest otherwise. I mean, how can you not like a show about aliens?
Yep, indeed. All right, let's go to the phones and talk about space travel, because that's what's on Brian's mind here this morning. Hi, Brian.